and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. What does it mean to love one another, even our enemies and sinners? Jesus expresses in this gospel what living for others means to you, to serve others rather than to be served. I am an ordained deacon in the Episcopal Church, which most of you are probably aware of. My primary function is to serve others, as Jesus relates to us in today's gospel. This gospel for today is a statement of Christian ethics, a very strong one, in fact, maybe the strongest one found in the New Testament. The context of our gospel for today takes place on the journey of Jesus and his apostles to Jerusalem, where Jesus will be crucified. He's told the disciples of this, but they misinterpret. They do not understand what he is saying. They see this journey as one where he will be placed in a position of power in relation to the Gentiles of power, the Romans, the leaders of the empire in which they reside. Jesus stands in opposition to the Romans. He is not a man of power, however, if they want their Messiah to be a man of power. His focus in this gospel is on the primary ethic of Christianity, to serve others, the poor, the oppressed, the needy of our society. This is what Jesus expects of us as Christians, not only to serve others, but even to die for them, as did all the apostles except John. John and James are, along with Peter, probably those of his disciples who are its closest associates. They are mentioned more than the others in the New Testament. John and James see themselves as part of the elite. They seek to be a part of God's hierarchy. They expect this to continue in heaven. They see themselves as Jesus' powerful disciples on earth. They do say that as Jesus asked, they can be baptized. They will drink the cup of wine as Jesus says, to die as Jesus does in his passion. He says this, but they do not understand it. Their role is to serve others, not to be served. This is what a deacon does, as should all Christians. We are to love one another, even our enemies and sinners. Jesus expresses in this gospel that living for others is what is expected of us. We are to give all we have to those who are less fortunate than we are. We are not to do as the wealthy man in last Sunday's gospel, to accumulate wealth, to despite others who are in such need. I would like to share with you who I am as a Christian today and have been in my whole life. I do not see myself as being perfect in what I do. I am also a sinner as are you. I'm not sure how I evolved to my present lifestyle. I do see it as a lifelong process. I do see myself as a spiritual person and have been for most of my life. When I was growing up, I related well to persons of difference. I wanted to be a school teacher for much of my childhood. I even prayed in the fifth grade that God would take over me and make me the fifth grade teacher rather than him. It did not work out that I could be a teacher. As I failed my student teaching assignment in an urban seventh grade class in Philadelphia. I got my BA degree in history, but had no plan to support myself. I was referred to the Department of Public Assistance in Philadelphia for a position. And when asked what I wanted to be, I said I wanted to be a humanitarian. And that just came out of me like that. This is what my goal in life was, to care for others. I was hired to be a caseworker in some of the poorest areas of the city. I loved the job. I had no fear of doing work in this environment. I felt I could relate to all persons as persons of value. I went to graduate school, received an MSW, Professional Social Work degree, and I continued in this profession for 45 years. I was a juvenile probation officer and ended my career as a professional psychiatric social worker, and also did some work in the criminal justice system. After I retired, I attended an Episcopal church. Guess which Episcopal church I'm referring to? All Saints in Benson Beach, and learned about becoming a deacon. The person who was the deacon at that time retired shortly after I came to this church. At that time, as a volunteer, I was looking for a calling for myself. I felt God's call to be a deacon and committed myself to becoming a deacon, which took 3.5 years to accomplish, but I did it. The diaconate is a ministry of caring for others in need, reaching out to others, those in need in our church and in the community. We try to bring the needs of the community to the church. We, as Christians, make vows to serve others as the deacon in an even more formal way, like when I was ordained as a deacon by the diocesan bishop at that time, Bishop Friday. When I was ordained, I made vows to the Episcopal Church and to all persons. I do this every year. I serve under the diocesan bishop. I try to follow as Christ has directed us to do. I look to the scriptures to guide me and serve as part of the liturgy here. I look for Christ in others and offer pastoral care to help them. I try to follow what Christ has directed us to do in today's gospel. I serve others. I serve others in need and do not look for others to serve me. Okay.